So hi guys, a very very good afternoon. Let us begin with SmartKira current affairs mock test 1st to 5th July. Which of the following countries has recently announced $41 million in aid as an additional assistance to India for its fight against COVID-19 as lawmakers cutting across party lines called for more? Kindly give the correct answer. The answer is that this $41 million aid was given by the country USA. So in USA there are two parties, Republicans and Democrats, right? So Democrats have elected Joe Biden. They have won, Democrats won, and Joe Biden is a party, he won from the party and he is the party president. And Republicans were the earlier president, that was Donald Trump. So cutting across party lines means that people from both the parties have said that India should be given more assistance. And they have given $41 million in additional assistance to India for its fight against COVID-19. The agency said that the US assistance to India is now up to $200 million with an additional $500 million more in emergency supplies and training for more than 2,14,000 frontline health workers. Which bank has selected TCS Bank's treasury solution to transform its operations, enhance risk management, offer a new generation of asset class coverage and ensure regulatory compliance? The answer for the same goes to that the bank that has chosen it is Commercial Bank of Kuwait. So Commercial Bank of Kuwait has made a pact with TCS banks to transform its treasury operations to manage risk better, enhance asset class coverage and drive future growth. One must note that the Kuwaiti dinar has one of the highest corresponding values with the dollar. So like one Kuwaiti dinar will give you $10. It's very different with regard to rupees. So for example, 1 rupee is sometimes, $1 is 80 rupees or 70 rupees. But Kuwaiti dinar is the highest, one of the most highest currencies that are prevalent. So the Commercial Bank of Kuwait have done a MOU with this TCS banks. Which country will provide India $10 million assistance to build cold chain facilities for safe storage of vaccines? The answer is that the country that will provide this $10 million assistance to build cold chain facilities for safe storage of vaccines is Japan. Japan gives us a lot of soft loans for the bullet train, for the Delhi Metro. Japan is always at the forefront for any kind of aid giving. It's always at the forefront. So Japan is a naturally true ally of the Asian subcontinent to us. It is also threatened by China. We are also threatened by China. Japan has conflicting interests with North Korea. We have conflicting interests with North Korea that we want democracy to come there. So Japan is one of our most trusted partners. Also, it is a partner in Quad. Quad is an organization of USA, Japan, India, and Australia. These are made on the initiative of Japanese PM in 2007, and it got fructified in the past year itself. So in 2007, it was the Japanese PM who gave the idea, Shinzo Abe, that Quad should be made to check the growth of China. So Japan is going to provide this $10 million assistance to build cold chain facilities for safe storage of vaccines. Union MSME Minister Nitin Gadkari has recently launched Indian Bank's MSME Prerna in which state? Kindly give the correct answer. So in which state the Union MSME Minister Nitin Gadkari has launched this MSME Prerna? The answer is that Nitin Gadkari has launched this MSME Prerna in Maharashtra. Indian Bank launches its flagship business mentoring program MSME Prerna in the state Maharashtra. MSME Prerna is a novel, unique and innovative business mentoring program, first of its kind to empower MSME entrepreneurs. Now what is micro, small and medium entrepreneurs? So this is actually Prerna. Prerna means inspiration if I translate it into Hindi. Prerna means if I translate it into English. And this is an initiative by the Indian Bank. And they are going to mentor this MSME entrepreneurs. In a bid to boost the startup ecosystem and promoting the transition to a low carbon lifestyle in Asia Pacific, which organization is in collaboration with Massive Earth Foundation and announced the launch of lowcarbon.earth? The answer is that UNEP will collaborate with Massive Earth Foundation for the launch of lowcarbon.earth. Carbon is the most prevalent polluter in our environment, and anything that reduces the presence of carbon is a boon to the environment. So this is a joint venture between UNEP and Massive Earth Foundation. The earth can absorb no more than 3 tons of CO2 emissions each year, and we have to keep it within tolerable limits, because if the temperature is not in tolerable limits due to carbon dioxide emission, then life becomes very difficult for the people who are living in coastal areas as seawater increases. Also for the landlocked masses, it will result in rainfall, unexpected rainfall, cyclones or typhoons, blizzards, any kind of unnatural event. Which country has recently launched 2 units of world's largest Bay Hethen hydropower station? So which country has launched? The answer for this is that these 2 units of world's largest Bay Hethen hydropower station were launched by China. So China, 2 units of China's Bay Hethen hydropower plant, said to be the largest under construction globally on Yangtze River, went on stream on Monday, generating electricity from the project for the first time as per news reports. The project's first 1 gigawatt turbine will begin formal operations after 3-day trial that began on Monday. Which Indian naval ship has participated in the joint exercise with friendly navies of Africa and Europe? So kindly name the naval ship. The answer is INS Tabar. So INS Tabar was deployed to participate in the joint exercises with friendly natives in Africa and Europe. The Tabar will conduct professional, social and sporting interactions. Ship will also participate in a number of joint exercises with friendly navies. So the area of during the deployment in which INS Tabar will cover is the Gulf of Aden, Red Sea and Suez Canal. Suez Canal, we all know that MV Evergreen, that was the container that blocked it. So the question can come. Red Sea and Gulf of Aden is basically from where the oil, all these things go on. So very, very important. Niti Aayog has recently convened National Convention on Prevention of Maternal, Adolescent and Childhood Obesity under the chairmanship of which person? So Niti Aayog has recently convened this National Convention on Prevention of Maternal, Adolescent and Child Obesity under the chairmanship of Mr. Vinod Kumar Paul, VK Paul, Dr. Vinod VK Paul. So Niti Aayog has convened this National Convention on Prevention of Maternal, Adolescent and Childhood Obesity under the chairmanship of Dr. V.K. Paul. So you just have to remember it, that obesity is a disease, it leads to many diseases, and that's why this prevention is better than cure, and that's why this is necessary. The third India-Bhutan Development Cooperation talks were held on 28 June in a virtual mode. Who among the following led Indian side in the talks? The answer is that this third Indian-Bhutan Development talks was led by, kindly give the correct answer, was led by Rahul Chhabra. So the third India-Bhutan cooperation talks, which were held on 28 June in a virtual mode, were led by Mr. Chhabra, and this is very, very ambassador, very, very important. And Mr. Rahul Chhabra is the Secretary of Economic Relations, Ministry of External Affairs. Our ambassador of India to Bhutan, Mrs. Ruchira Kamboj, was also present. Government has recently announced stimulus package of what amount to boost economy during the fight against COVID-19 pandemic? The answer for the same is that the government has announced 6,28,993 crore as the package for fight against COVID-19 pandemic. So the stimulus package of 6,28,993 crore to boost economy is to be given. Which cricket association has recently signed a lease agreement with Bokaro Steel Plant for the construction of International Cricket Stadium? The answer is that this cricket association's name is very important, Jharkhand State Cricket Association. So you can remember it with Mr. MS Dhoni's name. So Jharkhand Cricket State Cricket Association, affiliated with BCCI, has signed a lease agreement with Bokaro Steel Plant for the construction of an international cricket stadium. This stadium is located in Moaza Narkara. This land is located in Moaza Narkara, which will then be developed into a stadium on the south of National Highway 23. Which of the following date was observed as International Day of Parliamentarism 2021? The answer is that the day, International Day of Parliamentarism 2021, was observed on June 30. June 30 is observed as the International Day of Parliamentarism every year. The day was designated in 2018 by UN General Assembly. It marks the day of establishment of Inter-Parliamentary Union, Global Organization of Parliaments in 1889. International Asteroid Day 21 was observed on which date? The answer is that the International Asteroid Day was observed on June 30. So World Asteroid Day or International Asteroid Day is globally observed on June 30. Very important. India has recently presented English, Russian and Chinese translation of 10 classic works of modern literature written by prominent Indian authors in different languages to which organization? So India has officially given this literature written by prominent Indian authors of modern literature to SCO, that is Shanghai Cooperation Organization. So this was given in the headquarters of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Standard Life has recently sold shares worth Rs 6783 crore through an open market transaction. It is a promoter of which insurance company? So Standard Life is the promoter of which company? The answer is that it is a promoter of which insurance company? The answer is HDFC Life. So HDFC Life Insurance Company's promoter Standard Life on Tuesday offloaded shares worth 6,783 in the firm through open market transactions. So it held these shares and now they have shed it, right? Who among the following is the CEO of Niti Aayog that has recently got extension till June 2022? So it's a very important thing that you have to remember. The answer is Amitabh Kant. Amitabh Kant is going to be, his tenure is going to be extended and this is the third extension of the 65-year-old civil servant in the post. Reliance Industries has signed a strategic partnership with ADNOC to build a chloralkali ethylene dichloride and polyvinyl chloride production facility in which country? The answer is that Reliance Industries has inked pact with ADNOC to build a major project in UAE and they are going to build it in Abu Dhabi. Very important. So this Reliance Industries has decided that they are going to build a chloralkali ethylene dichloride and polyvinyl chloride production facility at Taha Aziz in Ruwais, Abu Dhabi. So the question can come is that where are they going to build this mega chemical project? The answer is Abu Dhabi. If the question comes that in which country, then the answer is UAE. With which company? Then ADNOC. Or ADNOC is going to build with which company? Then the answer is Reliance. Innovative Payment Solution, India's largest provider of payment solutions to enterprise merchants, and which digital payments platform has recently announced the pioneering facility of dual display UPI? The answer for the same is Innovative Payment Solutions and PhonePe. So Innovative Payment Solutions and PhonePe have partnered to pioneer this dual display UPI, an innovative, safer and superior UPI payment experience at Shoppers Stop. This novel feature will make it safer and faster for customers to pay through UPI while shopping at Shoppers Stop outlets pan India. Which small finance bank has partnered with Loan Tap Financial Technologies Limited, a digital lender, to provide personal loans to salaried professionals? The answer for the same is Ujjivan Small Finance Bank. So Ujjivan Small Finance Bank has partnered with Loan Tap Financial Technologies to provide personal loans to salaried professionals. Very important. Which private bank has made a multi-layer agreement with Amazon Web Services, the cloud computing arm of Amazon, to build a portfolio of new digital financial services with technology changes and new payment modes for better banking experience to its customers? Basically, Amazon Web Services are server experiences in which the net does not lag. So if you use SmartKeda, around 1.5 years back, 1.5 to 2 years back, we thought a need to upgrade to Amazon Web Services and now the site is on Amazon Web Services. So this digital financial services technology is very important because this gives a better usage to all our users and customers as net servers are always up. So this, which private bank has this made this deal? The answer is Axis Bank, headquarters in Mumbai. So Amazon Web Services have made this deal with Axis Bank to accelerate its digital transformation program and meet the growing demand of its digital banking services because the net servers of Axis Bank won't slow down now. World Health Organization, World Intellectual Property Organization, and which organization have recently launched a joint platform to tackle COVID-19 pandemic? The answer for the same is that World Health Organization and World Intellectual Property Organization and which organization have recently launched this joint platform to tackle COVID-19 pandemic? Kindly give the correct answer. The answer is WHO, WIPO and WTO. So, World Health Organization's Tedros Ghebreyesus, World Intellectual Property Organization's Darren Tang and World Trade Organization's Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala said that they want to map out further collaboration to tackle the pandemic. Now, this also gives a very, very this thing that Tedros is the head, World Intellectual Property Organization head is Darren Tang and World Trade Organization's head is Ngozi Okonjo. Now, this is very, very important to learn, these names, that who made the declaration. So they are coming together so that they can tackle the COVID-19 pandemic, because what is affected the most by COVID? Health, trade and property theft. So World Intellectual Property Organization, because everybody is on net. Bengaluru has recently ranked which number cities among the top 10 established technology submarkets in APAC according to a report by Colliers. So the answer is that Bengaluru has emerged as the top 5th established markets in the APAC, and this report was titled as Growth Engines and of Innovation, How Asia Pacific Technology Hubs are Reshaping Regional Real Estate. As per the recent report, which city has become the world's most expensive city for foreign workers? Kindly give the correct answer. The answer is that the city which has become the most expensive city for foreign workers is Ashgabat. So Turkmenistan's capital city Ashgabat has become the world's most expensive city for foreign workers, right? The annual report has ranked cities among 5 continents by measuring the comparative cost of more than 200 items. The survey used New York City, which ranked 14 on the list, right? Which Indian naval ship has recently conducted military exercise with South Korean ship in the East China Sea? Which Navy ship has conducted this? So the answer is that which naval ship has conducted? The answer is INS Kilton. So Indian Navy's indigenous ASW Corvette INS Kilton was deployed in the Far East, undertook Navy partnership in the East China Sea with the Republic of Korea Navy ship ARCOS Gengom. Very important. South Korea, with the South Korean vessel in the East China Sea for establishing the right of navigation in the South China Sea. Which of the following state has recently launched Jan Sahayak, Aapka Sahayak app and DSM AC scheme? The answer for the same is that this scheme was launched by Haryana Chief Minister. Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar on Wednesday launched Jan Sahayak, Aapka Sahayak to mobile app for government to citizen and business to citizen services. They have also announced a scheme for providing ownership rights to urban local bodies, property holders. Very important. Which state or UT has recently launched Hausla scheme to promote women entrepreneurship? The answer for the same is that the UT that has launched this Hausla scheme to promote women entrepreneurship is JNK. So Jammu and Kashmir has launched this Hausla scheme. So Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir, Manoj Sinha, launched this scheme Hausla for women entrepreneurs of the Union Territory, which aims at promoting their potential and enable a wider reach of the products and services. Goods and services tax day 21 was observed on which date? So the answer is very, very simple. You just have to answer that GST day is observed on which date? The answer is July 1. So on this year, the Union Finance Ministry issued appreciation letters to over 54,000 GST payers for timely filing of returns and cash payment of tax. So this is on July 1, 21. National Doctors Day 2021 was observed on which date? The answer is that the National Doctors Day 2021 was observed on June 30th. Doctors are important and they perform their duty like soldiers do, teachers do, and they save the lives of people. So for commemorating that, 30th June is celebrated. Which of the following date was the National Chartered Accountants Day? The answer for the same is July 1. So July 1 is the CA day. If your tax has been saved by a CA, July 1 is the appropriate day to remember him. Who among the following is the author of the book titled as Fiercely Female, The Datti Chand Story? So The Datti Chand Story has been written by whom? The answer is it is authored by Sundeep Mishra. So Sundeep Mishra and has authored this book about Datti Chand, India's first openly homosexual athlete from India, who scripted history in 2019 when she became the first Indian to win gold in a 100-meter event at World University in Naples. So he has written this. It is published by Westland Books. The book will be released on 22 June on soft cover. Name the person who was the editor of Sudharma, the world's only Sanskrit daily newspaper, who passed away recently. The answer for the same is that Sudharma's Sanskrit daily editor, Sampath Kumar, has passed away. So K.V. Sampath Kumar, editor of Sudharma, world's only Sanskrit daily newspaper, passed away. The print edition of Sudharma nearly had 4,000 readers. That means that 4,000 readers got the books, and there were many readers on the online section too. And he has said in a program that newspaper had readers from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. ICC has moved the 2020 World Cup from which country to UAE and Oman because of the pandemic? The answer is that the ICC has moved the country, moved the World Cup, T20 World Cup from India to UAE and Oman because of the pandemic. So now the World Cup will be held in UAE and Oman due to pandemic, because IPL was also stopped due to this raging pandemic in the country, and we are expecting a third wave due to the behavior of the tourists which are coming in Himachal, Uttarakhand, Jammu, Kashmir. Which Indian American has become the youngest chess grandmaster? The answer is Indian American Abhimanyu Mishra. So Indian American prodigy Abhimanyu Mishra became the youngest ever chess grandmaster after he scored his third GM nom in the Budapest, Hungary, according to a report. He is only 12 years old. The UAE's sovereign wealth fund Abu Dhabi Investment Authority has picked up a minority stake in which company for nearly $20 million? The answer for the same is Abu Dhabi Investment Authority has picked up a stake for nearly $20 million in MobiKwik. So UAE Sovereign Wealth Fund Abu Dhabi Investment Authority picked up a minority stake in the IPO-bound digital payment player MobiKwik for nearly $20 million, that is around 150 crore rupees. Amazon Web Services has acquired a messaging application which is a rival to Signal, and that messaging application is known as Vikr. So Vikr has been acquired by Amazon Web Services. This was founded in 2012 and boasts of emphasis on encryption. Very important. CCI has recently approved merger of which company with Synnex Corporation under Section 31(1) of the Competition Act 2002? The answer for the same is that CCI has approved the merger of Tech Tata Corporation with Synnex Corporation. So Tech Tata Corporation has made this with Synnex Corporation under Section 31(1) of the Competition Act 2002. Three students from which university has been awarded with prestigious the Dyna Award 21 for his exceptional contribution in changing the world with his COVID-19 innovation space era? The answer for the same goes to Jamia Millia Islamia student have been awarded the prestigious Dyna Award for exceptional contribution to the world with COVID-19 innovation. So carefully, fourth year student of BTech BArch Jamia Millia has been awarded the prestigious Dyna Award. Very, very important. Banking technology provider Network Public Services Technology has availed a registration for the third-party application provider from which organization for its TimePay solution? The answer is NPCI. So NPCI is the holder of UPI, and from NPCI, this banking technology provider Network People Services Technology has availed the registration for the third-party application provider. Which of the following bank has recently launched a banking solution for doctors called Salute Doctors? The answer is that the bank that has launched this thing is ICICI Bank. So ICICI Bank has launched this solution for doctors known as Salute Doctors. And this is a comprehensive banking solution for doctors. It provides customized banking as well as value-added service for every doctor, beginning from a medical student to a senior medical consultant to an owner or a hospital of a clinic. World Bank has approved what amount of loan program to support India's informal working class to overcome the current pandemic distress? The answer for the same is that the World Bank has approved $500 million loan. So USD $500 million loan was passed to support the informal working class amid the pandemic. World's first report on artificial intelligence in healthcare is released by which organization? The answer is very simple, if you can remember it. On healthcare, the answer is World Health Organization has released this first report on artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is going to be the future, and WHO has released the report. The report provides a valuable guide for countries on how to maximize the benefit of AI while minimizing risk and avoiding its pitfalls. The crash in international tourism due to coronavirus could be a loss of more than $4 trillion to global GDP for the years 20 and 21. Which organization has published a report regarding this? The answer for the same is that, which organization has said it? The answer is UNCTAD. So UNCTAD has said that the loss caused by pandemic can be $4 trillion due to global GDP. And it's a very big amount because most of the hotels and service providers have closed their shops in COVID-19 pandemic. India has recently been ranked at which place in the fourth edition of the Global Cybersecurity Index 2020? So India is ranked at which place in the fourth edition of Global Cybersecurity Index? The answer is that India has entered top 10 in the Global Cybersecurity Index 2020. So India is ranked 10th in the fourth edition of the Global Cybersecurity Index. A significant leap of 37 places from its previous GCI rank in 2018. Indian Navy has recently inked a pact with which organization to develop emerging technologies related to artificial intelligence, quantum computing and robotics? The answer for the same is that Indian Navy has signed the pact with Bharat Electronics Limited to develop emerging technologies related to artificial intelligence, quantum computing and robotics. So Indian Navy has inked this pact with Premier DPSU Bharat Electronics Limited to develop emerging technologies related to artificial intelligence, quantum computing and robotics. Which country along with India has recently begun construction of fifth unit of Kundakulam nuclear power plant? The answer for the same is that Russia has started to begin the construction of the fifth unit of the Kundakulam nuclear power plant. Which edition of the Foundation Day of the State Bank of India was observed on July 1, 2021? The answer is that the 66th Foundation Day of SBI was observed. So this is a question which can come. So 66th Foundation Day of SBI was observed. World Sports Journalist Day 2021 was observed on which date? The answer is very simple, that World Sports Journalist Day, the one who covered the sports news, they are in the stands. They take the interviews of the players for their fans. So that was observed on July 2. So World Sports Journalist Day is celebrated on July 2 each year. International Sport Press Association was established on this day in 1924 in the Summer Olympics in Paris. Very important. Who among the following has recently launched the Crop Insurance Awareness Campaign for Fasal Bima Yojana during the Crop Insurance Week? Kindly give the correct answer. The answer for the same is that Union Minister Shri Narendra Singh Tomar has launched this crop insurance awareness campaign for Fasal Bima Yojana during the Crop Insurance Week. Who among the following is the author of the book titled as The Struggle Within, A Memoir of Emergency? The answer is that The Struggle Within, A Memoir of the Emergency is published by HarperCollins and it's the book of Ashok Chakravarti. So Ashok Chakravarti has written this book, A Memoir of the Emergency, Struggle Within, right? This is over 1,50,000 people were imprisoned without trial, and this is one of the greatest dark periods in the Indian democratic history. So told through the experience of Arjun, author of Ashok Chakravarti, during his time as a part of an underground movement, the memoir begins with his return to India from Oxford in 1973, when he joins a group of left-wing activists seeking revolutionary change. Chief Minister of which state has recently released the book Jana Sukta Sut Shaurya, written by Dr. Gauri Shankar Sharma of Gaurish? The answer for the same is that Chief Minister Shri Chauhan. So Chief Minister Shri Chauhan of Madhya Pradesh. Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan has released the book Jana Sukta Sut Shaurya, written by Dr. Gauri Shankar Sharma, official sources said. It is related to Uttar Ramayana in a poetic yet uncomplicated form. In the recent ranking released by IHF, position of Indian men's hockey team is what in the... The answer is that India remains at the fourth place in the position of Indian men's hockey team. Right? Very important. Researchers have identified a new genus and species of land mollusk in the northern Western Ghats from Amboli village in which district? So this... land mollusk in the northern Western Ghats from Borali village in which district was found? The answer is that researchers have identified this new genus and species of land mollusk in the northern Western Ghats from Amroli village in Sindhu Durg district. So you can see it. It's a snail, and this new species of snail is found in Amboli in Sindhudurg district. Amboli village in Sindhudurg district. Which company has recently sent 36 satellites into orbit? The answer is very same. I have covered it in various questions even before. The answer is OneWeb. OneWeb is basically in partnership with Airtel, and they have sent more than 36 satellites into orbit. That will pave the way for rolling out commercial internet service in swaths of the northern hemisphere this year. How many asteroids have been discovered by Indian teacher-student duo in IASC Citizen Science program? Kindly give the correct answer. So the answer for the same is that 3 new asteroids were discovered by the Indian teacher-student duo in the IASC Citizen Science program. So Citizen-student duo with the Metropolis have found 3 new asteroids as a part of the International Astronomical Search Collaboration. Very, very important. Bala Bharti, alias OK Balakrishnan, principal, Bharti Matriculation Higher Secondary School, and G. Azimulikan, a first year BSc school physics scholar of St. Joseph College within the Metropolis, took half within the International Asteroid Search Campaign, whereby they found 3 asteroids. In the recent rankings released by International Hockey Federation, the position of Indian women's hockey team is? The answer for the same is that Indian women's hockey position team remains at 4th. None of these. So Indian men remains at 4th and women remains at 10th. Sorry, I just repeated this thing. So the answer is 10th for women and 4th for men. Because I was just wondering if the question was repeated. No, Indian men's is 4th and Indian women's is 10th. So kindly correct yourself because I made an error here. So Indian men's team will remain at 4th and 10th is for women in the FIFA, in this Federation of Hockey rankings. Who among the following is among the 34 immigrants honored by the prestigious American Foundation ahead of the US Independence Day, who have enriched and strengthened the US society and democracy through their contribution and actions? The answer is, kindly give the correct answer. Answer is Kamlesh Lula and Geeta Gopinath, that is A and B. So they are going to be honored. IMF Chief Economist Geeta Gopinath and NASA scientist Kamlesh Lula were among the 34 immigrants honored by the prestigious American Foundation ahead of the US Independence Day. Very important. Which of the following company has recently launched OmniCard, a prepaid card aimed at youngsters aged between 15 and 24 years? The answer for the same is that this is launched by Erute Technologies. So Erute Technologies is a fintech in the payment space, has launched this OmniCard, a prepaid cash card aimed at youngsters aged between 15 to 24 years. Right? This is the first prepaid instrument to be launched after the central bank allowed more features to be built into prepaid cards, building them on par with the payment banks. Guys, we will take a 3-minute break here. And we will continue with around 40 questions more. Which company has recently launched a non-linked, non-participating, single premium individual immediate annuity plan named Saral Pension Plan as per the guidelines of the IRDA? The answer for the same is that the company that has recently launched this plan named Saral Pension Plan is Life Insurance Corporation of India. So LIC has launched this Saral Pension Plan. In the LIC of India Pension Plan, policyholder can invest or pay a lump sum as a purchase price and get fixed payment at regular intervals for the rest of his life. Minimum annuity that policyholder can avail is 12,000 rupees per annum. Right? So very, very important. Reserve Bank of India has extended the validity of interest equalization scheme for pre and post shipment rupee export credit till which date? So RBI has extended the validity of interest equalization scheme for pre and post shipment rupee export credit till which date? The answer is that the RBI has extended this equalization scheme till September 2021. So this post and pre and post shipment rupee export credit scheme is extended till 30th September 2021. According to RBI's financial stability report, the scheduled commercial banks and gross non-performing assets are to rise by 8% in which year? The answer for the same is that the gross NPAs will rise to 9.8% by March 2022. Reason being COVID, lockdowns, and the non-growth of economy. So that will give reasons for the MSMEs as well as the big industries not to pay their loans, and they will gradually convert into NPAs. Right? So very, very important. According to RBI, the sustained policy support, benign financial condition, and gathering momentum of vaccination are nurturing an uneven global recovery. And that's what it is true, because in March, April, May, second wave struck India and NPAs are going to rise. As per the report by United Nations body, International Labour Organization, number of international migrant workers has risen globally to how many million dollars? How many million? International migrant workers have risen globally to how many million? The answer is that the migrated laborers, according to ILO, has risen to 169 million workers. So 169 million workers have increased, and this indicates an increase of 5 million migrant workers. Reason being that there is no jobs now in the indigenous spaces due to COVID, and that has broken the back of the economy, and that's why migrant workers are higher. As per the expectations of the International Energy Agency, India is going to add 26,000 megawatts of hydropower project by which year? The answer for this is that the 26,000 gigawatt hydro projects are to be done by 2030, and this is given by IEA. So IEA, that is International Energy Agency, has expected the country to add 26,000 megawatt of hydropower projects by 2030. Currently, the installed capacity of 207 hydropower projects in the country is 46,209 megawatt. Which edition of the Indian Ocean Naval Symposium was held at La Union recently? The answer is that the 7th edition of the Indian Ocean Symposium was held at La Union recently. So the 7th edition of the Indian Ocean Naval Symposium was hosted by the French Navy at La Reunion in Italy. It concluded on Thursday. Indian government ship's flagship program Digital India has recently completed 6 years. On which date it was launched 6 years back? That's why we can see that on which year it has completed. The answer is that July 1, 2021. What is the other day on which July 1 is important? That thing is GST day. So on GST day as well as the Digital India day have the same day, July 1, 2021. Digital India is very important because by connecting digitally we can make the payments faster, we can have the services faster, we can have a process of transparency. So very, very important. Who among the following has recently inaugurated Asia's longest and world's fifth largest HST in Pithampur, Indore, MP? The answer for the same is that Prakash Javadekar has inaugurated Asia's longest and world's fifth largest HST in Pithampur, Indore. So very, very important. This high-speed track is going to be the longest such track in Asia and fifth longest globally. And Prakash Javadekar said, now the ministers have changed and Prakash Javadekar is out. So very, very important, and the country is moving towards Atmanirbhar Bharat and all round efforts are being made in this direction. Arun Jaitley Institute, National Institute of Financial Management, and which company have formed a strategic partnership to build an artificial intelligence and emerging technologies center of excellence? The answer for the same is that Arun Jaitley's National Institute of Financial Management and Microsoft have formed this strategic partnership to build the AI. Very important, AI and emerging technologies of the center of excellence. So I've said that artificial intelligence is going to be the gold of the future, because now everything is coming to artificial intelligence. Even our cars like Tesla has started with automatic car driving. Very, very important. MOA was signed between Central Mine Planning and Design Institute and which organization for development of solar power projects? The answer for the same is that a memorandum of association was signed between CMPDI and CCL, that is the Central Coalfields for the development of these solar power projects. Because by this Central Coalfield project will create a green environment for offloading its carbon credits. You can see it here. The MOA will open the new path of CIL in becoming a net zero energy company. That means that it will not emit any more carbons more than it is not like solving. So it will have less pollution. Which organization has recently inked a memorandum of understanding with logistics service provider Aramex India to support micro, small and medium enterprise exporters in India? The answer for the same is FIEO, that is Federation of Indian Export Organization, has Saturday inked a memorandum of understanding with logistics service provider Aramex to support micro, small and medium enterprise exporters in India. Who among the following has recently released the report on United Information System of Education Plus for school education in India? The answer is that the person who has released this report was our Education Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal. Now the ministries have changed. Earlier it was Ramesh Pokhriyal who released this. Donald Rumsfeld has recently passed away. He was the former Defense Secretary of which country? The answer is that former US Defense Secretary. And you can remember it because the former president is also Donald Trump. And so Donald Rumsfeld is the correct answer. USA. Right, he has died at the age of 88, said his family in a statement. Who among the following has been qualified for the Tokyo Olympics in 400 meter hurdles after he clocked 49.78 seconds to win gold at the recently concluded Interstate Athletic Championship in Patiala? The answer is Indian Navy's MP Jabir. So Indian Navy's MP Jabir has qualified for the Tokyo Olympics as he won gold at the recently concluded Interstate Athletic Championships in Patiala. He clocked 749.78 seconds to win the gold. Jabir qualified through the world ranking quota where there were 14 spots available. Who among the following has recently won the Silver Lake Open Chess Tournament in Serbia? The answer is that the Silver Lake Open Chess Tournament in Serbia was won by Nihal Sarin. So Nihal Sarin has won the Silver Lake Open Chess Tournament in Serbia on Tuesday. The third seeded Indian came on the top of the field with 8 points from 9 rounds. Black-bellied coral snake has been discovered in which of the following states? Kindly give the correct answer. The answer for the same is that this black-bellied coral snake was first discovered in the state of Uttarakhand. Normally they are not found, but this black-bellied coral snake has been discovered in the forest of Uttarakhand for the first time in history. The snake belongs to LPD family of Somicorus, genus family named S. nigriventer. S. nigriventer. Which armed forces of India have signed an MOU with the Center for Development of Advanced Computing, CDAC, to train the manpower of the force in advanced technologies and undertake joint projects? The answer for the same is that CRPF. So Central Reserve Police Force is going to sign an MOU with Center of Development and Advanced Computing, CDAC, to train the manpower of the force. Very important. The MOU aims at augmenting the technical capacities of CRPF by training its manpower in advanced areas like Internet of Things, cybersecurity, artificial intelligence, high performance computing, and big data analytics. Which firm has recently announced the appointment of Mr. Nirutpal Gupta as the head of data science unit? The answer for the same is, the firm that has announced the appointment of Mr. Nirutpal Gupta as the head of data science unit is ICICI Securities. So ICICI Securities, India's leading retail-led equity franchise distributor of financial products, has announced the appointment of Mr. Nirutpal Gupta as the head of data science unit, taking another step in the direction of strengthening its data and analytics acumen. Which company has recently appointed the former Aston Martin chief Andy Palmer as the executive vice chairman and CEO of electric vehicle arm Switch Mobility? Kindly give the correct answer. The answer is Ashok Leyland. So Ashok Leyland has appointed Aston Martin chief Andy Palmer as executive vice chairman and CEO of electric vehicle arm Switch Mobility. Very important. Because from Aston Martin, the guy will come with a lot of experience. So Aston Martin chief Andy Palmer is now the executive vice chairman and CEO of electric vehicle arm Switch Mobility. Very, very important. World Bank has recently approved what amount of loan to cash strapped Pakistan financing schemes on clean energy and human capital development? The answer is that the World Bank has recently approved USD 800 million loan. So World Bank has approved this USD 800 million loan to cash-strapped Pakistan financing schemes on clean energy and human capital development, according to Pakistani media reports. The board of directors of World Bank approved two programs, Pakistan Program for Affordable and Clean Energy, PACE, and Securing Human Investments to Foster Transformation, that is Shift 2. Which of the following bank has recently launched Salaam Dil Se initiative to show gratitude to doctors? The answer for the same is that Salaam Dil Se attitude showing gratitude to doctors was launched by which of the following banks? The answer is HDFC Bank. So HDFC Bank has launched this Salaam Dil Se initiative. The initiative shows gratitude to the doctors for their tireless service during the pandemic. They have also launched the web platform www.salaamdilse.com. Which state CM has recently declared 20 lakh cash award to first fully vaccinated assembly constituency in the state? The answer for the same is the state that has recently declared 20 lakh cash award to first fully vaccinated assembly constituency is Manipur. So Manipur's current CM has announced this to a district because first fully vaccinated constituency got 20 lakh rupees. YSR Bima scheme with a new guideline and paid rupees 750 crore as the premium was launched in which of the following scheme? I hope you can guess it by YSR, that is Mr. Reddy, who was the earlier Prime Minister, earlier Chief Minister of the Joint Andhra Pradesh. The answer is Andhra Pradesh CM. Vice Jagan Mohan Reddy launched the YSR Bima scheme. YSR was his father and paid 750 crore as the premium. International Cooperative Day 2022 was observed on which date? The answer is that the International Cooperative Day was observed on July 2, 2021. So International Day of Cooperative observed every year on the first Saturday of July. This year, the International Day of Cooperative will be celebrated on July 4, 2020. IIAS Officer N. Venudhar Reddy took charge as the Director General of which company? The answer is that the IIAS Officer N. Venudhar Reddy took charge as the Director General of All India Radio. None of these is the correct answer. He took charge as the All India Radio head. He is an ISS officer of the 1988 batch and he today took the charge of Director General of All India Radio. Science and Engineering Research Board, SERB, and which company have launched first of its kind initiative that will enable Indians to pursue industry relevant research in the areas of deep technologies? The answer is that DST has partnered with Intel Technologies to enable Indians to pursue industry relevant research in the areas of deep technologies. So Science and Engineering Research Board and Intel India on Tuesday launched the first of its kind initiative that will enable Indians to pursue industry relevant research in areas of deep technologies. Department of Science and Technology, DST, said that the initiative called Fund for Industrial Research Engagement will help increase research opportunities in the space of artificial intelligence, machine learning, platform systems, circuit and architecture. Which organization has introduced a financial literacy textbook for the students of class 6 curated by National Payment Corporation of India? The answer for the same is that CBSE has introduced this book. So Central Board of Secondary Education has introduced this financial literacy textbook for the students of class 6 curated by NPCI. Very important, because financial literacy, if comes in the earlier age, makes situation very easier in the later life to manage money. Cabinet has recently approved an MOU signed between India and which country on refurbishing personal administration and governance reform? So Cabinet has approved this MOU signed between which country? The answer is that Cabinet has approved this MOU signed between India and the Republic of Gambia. Republic of Gambia, the answer is none of these. Republic of Gambia is the correct answer. Republic of Gambia. So Union Cabinet, chaired by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has approved the signing of MOU with the country of Gambia on refurbishing personal administration and governance reforms. Israeli defense major Rafael Advanced Systems has recently unveiled missile system called the Sea Breaker. What is the strike range of that missile? The answer is that Israel is one of the major targets of its neighbors, and that's why they keep on developing these missile systems, Iron Dome system. And you don't have to get confused with Rafale. That is French Dassault Rafale. This is Rafale Advanced Defense System. So that is French. This is Israeli. So the range for this missile system is kindly give the correct answer. The range is 300 kilometers. So this missile Sea Breaker can go. This is a long-range autonomous precision-guided missile system meant to hit high-value maritime and land targets, and this range is 300 kilometers. Can be fired from both land and surface ships. Very important. Now the question can come is that Israeli company has an existing joint venture with which Indian private firm? The answer is Kalyani, and it is called the Kalyani Rafale Advanced System. So it is good for India too. National Postal Worker Day 21 was observed on which of the following dates? The answer is quite simple, that the National Postal Worker Day was celebrated on July 1. GST date is celebrated on the same date, and July 1 is also the National Postal Worker Day. Postal workers are very important. They used to bring in the earlier time good news and bad news, but now they are important for official notification letters, Google verification letters, and in case you want to have some courier or some letter delivered officially. International Plastic Bag Free Day was observed on which date? The answer is that it was observed on July 3. As I am a resident and domicile of Himachal Pradesh, I can tell that reducing of plastic in Shimla, plastic bags, plastic polythene, has reduced our carbon footprint as well as reduced the pollution in the city of Shimla. Very important. Name the person who is the author of the book titled as India to the Rescue. The answer is that India to the Rescue, a children's book, is authored by Sushant Singh and Shruti Rao. That is A and C is the correct answer. Sushant Singh and Shruti Rao. I will repeat again. Sushant Singh and Shruti Rao has written this book, India to the Rescue. This is a children's book and told in an adventure mystery style. It is full of twists and turns, taking young readers aged 7 and above on a secret flight and ride on tiny boat through inky darkness. Who among the following has authored the book titled Nathuram Godse, the true story of Gandhi's assassin? The answer is that, who is going to author this book? The answer is, it will be published by Macmillan, and the book is written by Dhaval Kulkarni. So Dhaval Kulkarni has written this new book on Nathuram Godse. According to the official title, the book titled Nathuram Godse, True Story of Gandhi's Assassin, will release in 2022. Which company has recently launched 7 satellites from 747 plane? The answer is that Branson's Virgin Orbit has launched 7 satellites from 747 plane. Right? Very important. So Boeing 747 plane was used to launch 7 satellites, and this is very important, very, very important, because now planes are used as launch pads, right? Green Robotics has designed and developed India's first indigenous drone defense drone called Indra Jal. The firm is based in which city? So Green Robotics has designed this, and this is India's first indigenous drone defense drone called Indra Jal is based in Hyderabad. This Green Robotics has been based in Hyderabad. As per the company, Drone Defense Dome has the capability to autonomously protect an area of 1,000 to 2,000 square kilometers against aerial threats by assessing and acting on aerial threats such as unmanned aerial vehicles, loitering munitions, and low radar cross-section targets. Edelweiss Group has recently announced their investment of how much stake in the Edelweiss Galghar Insurance Broker Limited? The answer is that 100% stake has been given to Galghar Insurance Brokers Limited. So it has sold its entire stake in the insurance broking joint venture to the existing promoter Galghar & Co. So the Galghar & Co. is based in US and Edelweiss has gone out of it. Name the person who has been appointed as the chairman of Indian Federation of United Nations Association. The answer is that the person who has been appointed as the chairman of IFUNA is Shambhunath Srivastav. So Shambhunath Srivastav, former Allahabad High Court judge, has been appointed as the chairman of Indian Federation of United Nations Association. Justice Srivastav succeeds Mukul Sangma, former Chief Minister of Meghalaya. Who among the following has been honored with the highest civilian award of Mongolia, the Order of Polar Star? The answer is that the person who has been honored with the highest civil award of Mongolia is Shri R.K. Sabharwal. Shri R.K. Sabharwal, CMD, Engineers India Limited, was honored with the highest civilian award of Mongolia, the Order of the Polar Star, by His Excellency, President of Mongolia. Which firm has been awarded the world's most innovative investment promotion agency 2021 by OCO Global? The answer for the same is that the firm that has been awarded the most innovative investment promotion agency 21 by OCO Global is Invest India. So Invest India has been awarded for the most investment promotion agency 2021 award. Reserve Bank of India has imposed a monetary penalty of what amount on Punjab and Sindh Bank? Very important and very, very easy to learn. So the penalty on Punjab and Sindh Bank is 25 lakh rupees. Easy to learn. Government of India has recently extended retirement age of what, how many years of LIC chairman to how many years? The answer is that the LIC chairman's age is now going to be, the LIC chairman's retirement age is going to be 62 years. So government has extended the superannuation age of IPO bound LIC chairman up to 62 years by making an amendment to the Life Insurance Corporation of India Regulations 1960. NABARD has recently sanctioned 388 crore for drinking water and road projects in which state? The answer is that NABARD has sanctioned this drinking water and road projects in the state of Odisha. So in Odisha, NABARD has sanctioned this assistance of 388 crore in the Odisha under Rural Infrastructure Development Fund, RIDF, for setting up 4 mega piped water supply projects. These projects will come in Koraput district, Balasore district, Malankirigiri district. Right? Very, very important. WHO has recently awarded a malaria-free certificate to which country? The answer is that the WHO has awarded this malaria-free certificate to China. So WHO has awarded this malaria-free certificate to China, and they have said that when the country has demonstrated with rigorous, credible evidence that the chain of indigenous malaria transmission by Anopheles mosquito has been interrupted nationwide for the past 3 consecutive years, that means that malaria is eliminated from that country. Thank you very much for watching, dear friends. I hope to see you in another lecture in which we will cover current affairs from 6th to 10 July in this evening. Thank you.